Sorry about that last cut in episode 10, that sudden stop. I had not realized that I had gone over my time. I try to keep a stop clock here, a stopwatch here next to me to try to judge and see whenever my time is starting to go over, but sometimes Bandicam decides that it's been 10 minutes before a stopwatch does. But there we go. Back to the fun stuff. Here we go. We're just going to lower this a little bit. No, wrong way. Wrong way. There we go. You see these RCS thrusters are a little bit sensitive. We're actually coming into the atmosphere kind of hot. What I'm going to do is what is known as a retro burn. I'm going to go ahead and see that little green dot there. We're going to make sure that whenever we come back around this way, it's going to have an X in the middle, and we're going to power thrust as fast as we can with as much of the rocket fuel as we can. I really overdid this rocket for what it is. And then we're going to put it in all fours and go. Whoa, come back. Get back in there. Okay. Now, with the, you can see this is actually seriously considerably decreasing, although it really doesn't matter because we're in the upper part of the atmosphere and falling fast. But what this will do is help control just about where you want to land. It's a lot more helpful in higher orbits. Maybe I'll do a video on that later. But I hope this small little three-part episode has been enough to help you understand exactly what goes into rocket design. I know that at least one of you have asked for a little bit more of a detailed rocket build, and that's pretty much all I do to put in my rockets, is that right there. And what I'm doing now is I'm cutting my thrusters and disengaging everything, and I'm just gonna fall back to Earth and just go ahead and hit the parachute here. I'm gonna go ahead and pause the video here, and then we'll get back when we get closer to land. Okay, we're back, and the chute is opened. We're in the middle of an ocean. No land in sight. And with that said, that is basically how I go through and test through trial and error what type of rockets work and what types don't. There we go. Who knows? I may even put a montage of some of my worst fails ever. Because let's admit, we all have some crazy designs whenever we want to build rockets, right? But there you go. Thank you very much. Y'all have a great day. Okay, everything's going good. Let's go back to here. Oh, stupid lazy thumb. Oh no, I'm attached to a out-of-control rocket. I can't control the throttle on that thing at all. Yeah, uh-oh. This isn't good. This is not good. Ooh, we are plummeting very quickly, too. That's a big blue ocean coming in front of me. Let's try to engage this, if we can leave it. Yeah, look at there, we can leave it. Bye-bye, loser. Hope you have fun traveling out there in space. By yourself. Bye-bye, there it goes. Becomes a twinking little star. Bloop! And then it just disappears. That'd be nice. Alright. And go ahead and kill that. Try to turn this thing around. So that way we can approach vector burn. Or retro burn. Whatever. You know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah. I'm going to try to land it in the ocean. Or maybe that landmass there. Let's hope. Who knows? Maybe the landmass will work. Oh, stupid lazy thumb. I'm going to cut you off and feed you to my dog. I swear it. Okay, this is the Bogey 701 going for test flight number 2. Hopefully we won't die and burn this time. Firing 3, 2, 1. What the? No! What the? How'd that happen? Disengage! Disengage! This is not good. Not good. Open the chute. Barely made it above a kilometer. How'd that happen? Solid rocket boosters. You are my nemesis. I hate you so much. I just hope we don't land in the explosion. Can you imagine if shrapnel just started through that chute? That would suck. Oh well. At least this was not going on YouTube.